Today, we're going to look at three of the most common annoyances in typesetting: widows, orphans, and runts, and how to set up a style sheet in InDesign to deal with them automatically. We'll go over the settings you need to deal with them, and also sprinkle in a little bit of grep to finish off. So stick around. Basically, when someone is talking about widows or orphans in relation to type, they're referring to leftover lines at the beginning or end of some block of type. For the sake of specifics, a widow occurs when the last line in a column of text breaks across the top of the next column on the page. Conversely, an orphan occurs when the first line of a new paragraph remains at the end of a column of type, while the rest of the paragraph breaks to the next column. Very often, though, the terms are also used to describe when a single word is left on a new line at the end of a paragraph. Although it doesn't really matter too much, since usually most people will understand anyway, the correct term for this single word occurrence is actually a runt. When you're setting a large amount of text, these annoyances can waste a lot of time if you try to fix them manually. Fortunately, it's incredibly easy to fix widows and orphans automatically, just using InDesign's paragraph style settings. Runts require a little bit more configuration, but they can also be handled using styles, so you never need to manually deal with them again. So let's get to it. We'll deal with the widows and orphans first, since they really are ridiculously simple to fix. Just open up your paragraph style and go to the Keep Options section. The first group of settings are used to stop your text from breaking from whatever other text follows it. So this is useful if you are setting up a style for a heading, for instance. But what we're looking for is the next group down, the Keep Lines Together setting. And so, to prevent any widows or orphans from occurring anywhere in your text, all you need to do is check this box. Literally, that's it. The default start and end settings will always keep the first and last two lines in each paragraph together. You can adjust this as needed, but yeah, that's all you need to do to take care of widows and orphans in your document. Apply this setting to a base style, and then use for all subsequent styles, and you will have no widows or orphans anywhere in your document. As you can see, the orphans paragraph style here is based on the widows style, and so it's already inherited the same setting. Now, moving on to runts. To fix runts, we need to dabble a little in one of InDesign's powerful but slightly intimidating features: grep styles. Trying to cover grep in depth is definitely beyond the scope of this video, but we will have a quick look at how this particular grep string we're using actually works. The main thing to remember about grep is that it's a long-standing way of searching for particular patterns in text. To deal with runts, you first need to set up a new character style. Under the Basic Character Format section, go over to No Break and just check the box. Then hit OK, that's all that's needed. Then open your paragraph style and go to the Grep Style section. Hit the New Grep Style button and you'll have, strangely enough, a new grep style. All grep styles do is find a particular pattern within your text and apply a character style to it. In this case, the default settings will find any numbers in your text and apply the character style of None to them. Not a terribly useful default. However, if you replace the default grep pattern with something a little more interesting, and then select an actual character style to apply, then just like that, no more runts. It's like really dull magic that kind of looks as if someone fell asleep on the keyboard. Don't worry, the pattern is written down in the video description, so you can just copy and paste from there. So how does this particular bit of grep work? It's fairly dull magic? Basically, what's going on is that the string is telling InDesign to search for the end of paragraph marker, and then from there it just counts back two words. In every paragraph that the style is applied to, it will find the pattern of end of paragraph preceded by two words separated by a space, and it applies the no break character style to those elements. In case you find a line is just too long and you have no choice but to leave a single word on its own line, just put a space at the end of the paragraph and this will cancel out the grep style for that paragraph without needing to change your styles or apply any overrides. Of course, if it seems to not be working for you in the first place, this could be because you already have a space at the end of the paragraph. That about does it for now. Hope this was some use to you. Thanks for watching.